which 5 things we should do for our finances during the pandemic. The pandemic started since early 2020 does not seem to be ending too soon. Many businesses in Malaysia are now affected, especially during current lockdown. And honestly, we do not know when this will come to an end, and there's nothing much we can do about it. It is better for us to get prepared rather than worry something that we cannot control. So let's have a look at what we can do to help ourselves during the pandemic. Hi, my name is Eva Wong and I'm a wealth coach who teaches people how to manage their finances better so that they can retire early. Over the last 10 years, I've built my own investment assets which are now able to generate consistent 5-figure passive income. Hence, after quitting from my full-time job a few years back, I now fully focus on my own financial management and sharing with more people on financial knowledge. I shall be sharing more videos on the financial management topics, specifically on early retirement on the YouTube channel. If you're watching my video for the first time, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell button so that you will be notified on my upcoming video uploads to get more personal finance tips. The first thing we can do is to visit our monthly cash flow. Cash flow is the king. Clarity is the key. Is our current monthly cash flow now positive? Predict the upcoming 6 months income and expenses. Have a feel on how the ongoing lockdown and pandemic are going to affect our cash flow. Try to find ways to cut down the expenses so that we can have more savings for the rainy days. Things are unexpected now. More cash means more security. Yes. You can find the link and description below for a template to key in your financial data to check your monthly cash flow. Second, we need to have a look at our emergency fund. Make sure that we have at least 6 months' expenses as our emergency fund to cope with any upcoming unforeseen circumstances. If you have not set up your emergency fund, then you need to go through all your saving accounts, investment accounts to identify the emergency fund sources. Understand where we can source emergency fund. Is it fixed deposit? Is it saving account? Or is it still in the investment account? If the emergency fund is not in the bank yet, it is time to do some switching of the investment to lower risk assets investment to allow for any flexible withdrawal without affecting the investment performance. Third, look for opportunity to refinance the long-term property loan. Currently, as you know, the OPR is low. The Bank Negara has reduced the OPR 4 times in the year of 2020 from 3% to 1.75%. Yes, you didn't see it wrong. It is more than 40% reduction. If the loan has been taken quite a while, the interest could be high compared to what the current bank can offer now. This can potentially reduce your monthly loan installment. It is also possible to prolong your installment period if you are young enough. This will reduce your monthly expenses too. For example, if you bought the property in 2010 at $450,000 and the loan amount is $405,000 with monthly loan installment of $2,350, after paying the loan installment for 11 years, the outstanding loan amount will be roughly around $320,000. You can choose to lower the interest only by paying lesser installment by committing to pay in another 25 years time. Loan installment shall be reduced from $2,350 at 4.85 to $1,540 at 3.15. In addition, if you need some cash, you might be able to cash out some money from this exercise too, if the property you bought has increased in price. In the last example, the property value has increased from $450,000 to now $800,000 in the past 11 years. One can choose to refinance it up to maximum of 80% of the property value to get some cash back. 80% of $800,000 is $640,000 and the outstanding current loan is $320,000. In this case, one can choose to cash out the difference subject to the loan approval. Note that If you're cashing out the extra amount, loan installment amount will also increase accordingly. If you know you can get more return from cashing out from the refinance exercise, it is good. But if not, don't even cash out. Just apply for the interest reduction. Fourth, learn and start investing. As I've emphasized in my previous videos before, investing is the key to grow our wealth. If you're having some excess cash, make sure you look into various investment vehicles. You shall not be saving a lot of money in the bank apart from your emergency fund. Currently, the saving rate is only less than 2%.
Wow.
OPR has been reduced 4 times in the year of 2020. It is just not enough to cope with the inflation. Watch my previous video on saving and investment to understand the impact of investment on your wealth. There are many ways you can start invest. For example, you can look into stock investing, unit trust fund, index fund, real estate investment trust. Make your excess money work for you and your future will thank you for doing it now. Number 5, you can create a second source of income stream during the lockdown. During the lockdown period, there are many opportunities online. You can consider learning a new skill to start create another income source for yourself. Since last year, I've seen many are selling things online via YouTube channel and social media. Even for myself, I've started to teach online, which I can earn from these online classes. You see, you can actually turn your passion into extra income stream too. Do not waste your time. Start to learn a new skill to help yourself during the lockdown. Let's have the summary for the 5 things that we should do for our finances to get prepared for the pandemic. First, we need to have a look at our cash flow and look for ways to reduce our expenses. Second, set up our emergency fund. And third, look for opportunities to refinance our long-term property loan. And fourth, start investing to grow our wealth. And five, start to create our new income source. Remember, we cannot control what happened to us, but we are able to do something to get prepared to the pandemic. If you like what I've shared, please click the subscribe button to my YouTube channel and leave a comment on what topic you would like me to share more in the future. Thank you for your time, and I hope to see you again in my next video. Bye!